It is Tuesday, July 20th. Can you believe it? Already a month past the summer solstice. You can see the sun is starting to move northward again. You can see the sunset's coming a little bit earlier. It really starts to dive in August, but the days are so beautiful. Still hot and muggy here, big thunderstorms in the northeast and eastern U.S., and it's been a summer. It's been warm, hot, humid. Bit of Summertime by the Gershwins. It's been that kind of hot summer. It has been hot and muggy and hot. And again, welcome to you. Welcome. I can't believe your face is at my door. Welcome. You've been on my mind forevermore. Welcome. Put down your burden to stay. It's so good to see your beautiful smile. Stay as long as your feet need to rest. Stay, recharge your soul. Stay, for my heart has truly missed you. Stay. Consider this your start. Tell me, am I somewhere in your heart? And stay as long as your feet need to rest. Stay, recharge your soul. Stay, oh, my heart has truly missed you. Consider this your home. For some water here. Professional fade there. An original tune of mine called Stay. Parenthetical title, Welcome. And we play that a lot to open the song, to welcome you and say it's always good to see your face. So... again, it is Tuesday, July 20th, And I've got that microphone boom up there and all kinds of stuff going on today. Again, we always welcome you and hope you and yours are well, safe, kind, positive, and happy. Hope you guys are vaccinated, if not getting vaccinated really soon. This Delta variant of the COVID-19 virus is kicking butt. It is ripping through unvaccinated communities and unvaccinated states. It's stronger. It communicates more quickly. It has stronger lasting effects. And unfortunately, hospitalizations are rising. Deaths are rising again. Wow, we have just got to nip this thing in the bud. You know, this is science, folks. Please heed Mother Nature and get vaccinated as soon as you can. We've got a really quick public service announcement on COVID, where a good place for tool for you to figure out where you can get vaccinated. And it's going to be real short thing here. Hey, as you know, health.pa.gov is the health site for Pennsylvania, and same for your state. Look and find it. Just look for the health department. And the main page of every Department of Health in every state has COVID right on the front page. So there's COVID-19 at healthpa.gov right on the main page. You have the power to help end COVID-19. You click on Learn More. And it says right here, look at all of these links. Get vaccinated is the first one. Pennsylvania's plan, vaccine clinics, vaccine distribution, vaccine safety, before you vaccine, vaccine frequently asked questions, vaccine resources, et cetera, et cetera. Hey, let's click the first one, really easy, get vaccinated. So look at this, this is vaccines.gov. This is a national site which allows you to put in a zip code. You can actually select which vaccine you want here, see it? The Moderna, Pfizer, BioNTech for ages 12 and above, and of course, J&J Janssen. So I'll put in a zip code in kind of the center area where we are here, which is Lansdale, I think, in eastern Pennsylvania, about, 25 miles, 30 miles from Pennsylvania. And when I click on that, I get dozens and dozens of, look at all of these locations just within the 25 mile segment of Lansdale. In all of them, in East Norriton and White Marsh and North Wales and Skippack and Chalfont, Telford and Franconia. And these aren't even huge population centers. Look at this. The vaccine is readily available. Look at this. All of these pharmacies. All of these hospitals, unbelievable. Oh. So there it is, folks. Vaccines.gov, put in a zip code, and you are definitely, definitely good to go. Let's end this share. Pretty easy to do. So, make sure that those who you're talking to can readily get the vaccine and encourage them to do so, please. It's a true story. My dad trained the young men in small artillery. In the Carolina summer heat, 1943, he choked up and prayed Godspeed the day the boys left town. And as the train pulled out, he cried, take those fascists down. Take those fascists down. Swam off the Higgins to the Iwo Jima sand, crawled face down through the jungle, a gun and prayer in his hands. He would never walk again, a sniper his spine had found, but until the day he died, he cried, we
took those fascists down. We took those fascists down. Now they're crawling out from under rocks, crying racial supremacy, building laws and walls and cages. The name they used to seek cred, but today, as through all time, they must be put in their stead. There's more of us than them in every American town. So hit the streets and the voting booths and take those fascists down. Take those fascists down. Take those fascists down. Take those fascists down.
An original tune I wrote last year, 2020, called Take Those Fascists Down. And yes, it's a true story. My dad did train the young men in artillery, small artillery, in World War II. And my uncle, sadly, was paralyzed in the Pacific Theater in World War II. So brave people. They knew that fascism was dark and crippling, and it was going to kill the planet and put everyone under their knees, especially Hitler. Just insanity. So they took those fascists down. It's good to be anti-fascist. It's good to be Antifa. You have to be anti-fascist. You must be about democracy and voting and lots of great behaviors that America is striving to improve every day. Make sure you're on the side of trying to make things better and not trying to tear it down. So that was called Take Those Fascists Down. Hey, let's see here quickly. Another really quick PSA, kind of public service announcement. And it is about how do you contact your officials? We said, you know, we're in our 71st consecutive week here, and we spent a lot of last year on basic health information and vaccine information and voting and how to register and where you can vote and all that stuff. And you guys did just a wonderful, wonderful job. And now this year we're transitioning to being more active, you know, to be really taking all of these small actionable things that let elected officials know what you want, because that is the most effective thing. You have to stay in their faces. And that includes contacting them, texting them, emailing them, commenting on their official Facebook and Instagram and Twitters, and, you know, let them know how you want America to be. So again, for traditional contacts, so you've got USA.gov. USA.gov is the portal site for the United States government. You can find anything here. We're looking at the fourth item in the menu here, government agencies and elected officials. Let's click that. And here you go. and all the topics in government agencies and elected officials drop down. And we want this third one. Contact elected officials. And there it is. So now your page up there is usa.gov/elected-officials. usa.gov/elected-officials. How do you contact your elected officials? It's all right here. It's all set up for you at the federal level. How do you contact the president and the White House? How do you find who your U.S. senators are and your U.S. representatives and what their official contact information is? That's for the federal level. For the state level, same thing. How do you get in touch with your state governor? What's the official ways to communicate with your governor? And who are your representatives and state representatives and state senators in your state legislature? That's the second level. That's state officials. And the third level, of course, is local. How do you find your mayor by name, city, or population size? How do you find your county executive to communicate with them? You can do a zip code search. And you can get contact information right down to your county and your town officials. So three levels: federal, state, local, and that is usa.gov/elected-officials. Stay active, be active, be heard. It's a very good thing to do. That's usa.gov.
Say one thing to
I just need him to say, I just need him to say,
listening to that one. That was a song called Sin, C-Y-N, someone's name. I wrote that 2020, June of 2020. And that goes out to a dear old friend. I hope you enjoyed that song. Well, that's the second time I've ever played that. It is. I think I realized why I don't play it that often as I was playing it. It's a tough one to get through. And every songwriter has those. It's some... Always some challenging stuff. Hey, let me see if there's anything else we're supposed to be doing here. One last real quick PSA here. Let's do a share screen on it. Hey, we talked about being more actionable and more action-oriented. And of course, there's a checklist that comes out every other week that's organized as a checklist with links already set up for you to do stuff for you. Wow. It's called the Americans of Conscience Checklist. AmericansofConscience.com. Great, great list. You can subscribe to the checklist at their page just by clicking right there. They have a good Facebook page too, and they're on Twitter, and they're on Instagram. They are wonderful. And this is all about positivity. If you believe that diversity is our greatest strength, that respect, truth, and compassion matter, and they were all called to love our neighbor, you are an American of conscience. What is in the Americans of Conscience checklist? A list of clear, well-researched actions in support of things we can all agree on. Democracy, voting access, equality, basic respect for aspiring Americans, and thank you notes to people who are doing this stuff. It encourages good news about the values we share, good news and action. What's not in the Americans of Conscience checklist? No partisan BS, name-calling, insults. No exclamation marks, yelling, no vilifying, no conspiracy theory or lies, no scary hype, none of that stuff. Let's just all be positive and let's work off a fact-based reality. Oh my, oh my, oh my. Here's your latest checklist up here, Americans of Conscience Checklist, July 16th, 2021. So, and here we go. There are 9 actions in this most recent checklist. How do you oppose barriers to voting in your state? What you can do for that. You click on that, and it tells you what's happening with barriers that are being put up to voting. In 43 states, 253 bills have been introduced to restrict voting. Unbelievable. It's old Jim Crow. This is old Jim Crow from the post-Civil War and the first half of the 1900s. They're trying to bring back just, you know, the insane stuff they've been doing to block people from voting. It is crazy. You can enter your zip code and verify your constituents. They say call your state legislature, and there's a lookup provided right there. And you can share your, they give you a good script. Share your town or your zip code, identify yourself as a constituent, state your support for any specific bills or whether or not you're against specific bills that are trying to block voting access. And you can consider a donation to Spread the Vote, which is a great, great organization that's trying to fight for voting access for all people. You can also, action 2, here's the next one, empower future voters for the 2022 midterm elections. You can use Spread the Vote's effort to assist people in obtaining IDs. It's crucial. That ID is required for medical care and vaccinations. IDs save lives. And there's the newest kind you can donate. Encourage high school students to learn about voting. So again, and there's resources here, and the Civics Center is the resource, and you can go to that center, and they have actions already defined, and you can reuse in your local school district to teach high school students about access to voting and healthy access to voting for all people. So again, that's how this checklist is organized. Lots of really clear actions. They focus only on 5 to 10 in each checklist. It comes out every couple of weeks. By all means, take a look at it. AmericansOfConscience.com or Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. Take action. Be positive. Be energetic. It's the best thing to do. Hey, that is what we're going to do for a wrap this week. This has been 3 songs for Prometheus. I'm Tom Cooney. Thanks for tuning in and listening. You can see this in the archive playlist, 3 songs for Prometheus, on Tom Cooney Music YouTube. That's a good place to find it. I'll share a link to it over on Facebook, too. And I hope you and yours are well. Be safe, be kind, be positive, be happy, be actionable. Everyone be well. See you next Tuesday at 4 p.m. Eastern Time on Tom Cooney YouTube for 3 songs for Prometheus.